Hello students, welcome to Allforce e-learning. Now let us go for finding the equation, line equation, that in x and y intercept form. X and y intercept form. So we know the line equation only with y intercept form. There y is equal to mx plus c, y is equal to mx minus c, y is equal to minus mx minus c. That is only in y intercept form. We know those equations. We made exercise over it. And now this is again line equation but with two intercepts x and y. Okay. So equation of line with x and y intercept form. Right. Let us consider a straight line. A straight line, so which gives x-intercept. This is x-intercept, say, and y-intercept, so B. Now, coordinates of this point. So this point is A comma 0, and this point is 0 comma B. Now coordinates are these are x1 comma y1 and these are x2 comma y2, right? And here angle made by this straight line with positive x axis is acute angle. Acute angle, that is theta greater than 90 degree. So we can expect that, we can decide that slope. Slope of line is negative. Right, let us verify the slope negative or positive after finding the equation. By equation also we can verify that. By the fundamentals as we know that if angle is obtuse and definitely that slope will be negative. We know this, but again we verify that by the equation after deriving that. Okay, so we know the line equation formula. When the line is passing through a point x1 comma y1, so equation of line is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Okay, right, let us find the slope from it. Slope of the line, see here x1 comma y1, so which is a comma 0, x2 comma y2, which is 0 comma b. Okay, slope of the line, so m is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So m is equal to y2 is b minus y1 is 0 by x2 is 0 minus x1 is a. Therefore slope of this line is minus b by a. This is the slope. So as we decided over here at the beginning that angle is obtuse. Angle is obtuse when angle made by the straight line with positive x axis, which is obtuse angle, and slope will be negative. The same it is reflecting, slope is minus b by a. Keep it aside and go for the line equation that in intercept form, which is x and y intercept form. As we know that line equation, the line is passing through a point x1 comma y1 is given by y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1, right? Y minus y1 is equal to 0, slope minus b by a. X minus x1 is equal to a, right, y is equal to minus b by a x minus r minus plus a b by a. So b remains here, a cut minus r minus plus multiplying this a b by a, b remains, and it is similar to y is equal to mx plus c. So very clear, it is similar to y is equal to mx plus c. So comparing them, slope from here also we can say slope m is equal to minus b by a. So intercept is, y intercept is giving b is a y intercept, right? Convert that into intercept form. So from here this is y is equal to, again taking LCM here, minus b x plus a b by a, and take this side a y or y a is equal to minus x b plus a b, and take this side x b plus y a, or otherwise we can write it as bx, take this term, this side, so it becomes positive bx plus ay minus ab is equal to 0. Okay, ab is equal to 0, then you will get from this equation also slope. So if the format is given bx plus ay minus ab is equal to 0, then slope in this case, slope is equal to minus x coefficient of x by coefficient of from this slope equal to coefficient of x is x coefficient b minus b by, so coefficient of y is a. So in this way you can also decide the slope of the line. And next one is, so intercept form, x and y intercept form, the equation can be obtained. See here, from equation, this one, from this equation, from equation 2, from equation 2, so modify that equation. See, this is bx plus ay is equal to, take this side ab, right, divide by ab on both sides, then you will get x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. So x by a plus y by b is equal to 1 is the line equation in intercept form, that is x and y, where x intercept, where a is x intercept and b is y intercept. So this is the final equation, equation number 3, right? So this is the line equation with x and y intercepts, x and y intercepts. Yes, it's relevant, graph is given clearly. This is the straight line, we can say it's a relevant graph here, and from the graph we derived this formula. Then again we verify that with this equation, see x intercept is a, y intercept is b. So this is the straight line equation in x and y intercept form. Okay, example 1 and example 2. So this is the equation 3x plus 4y is equal to 12, and this is 2x minus 3y is equal to 6. So in x and y intercept form, so convert that into x and y intercept form, because our concept is the line equation, straight line equation with x and y intercept form. So we are going to find slope of the line and also plot the graph between x and y. Here also find the slope of the line and plot the graph between x and y, right? So what is the nature of the graph? How it is oriented? Straight line here, and here the straight line is oriented. How it is? Let us see, let us verify. Now in this case, so let us convert this into x and y intercept form, a very simple, where it is divided by 12 on both the sides. 12. Now simplify this. 3x by 12 plus 4y by 12 is equal to 1. 3 4 ja, 4 3 ja. Then x by 4 plus y by 3 is equal to 1. This is straight line equation with x and y intercepts. Okay, so what is the equation of slope? Slope m is equal to minus b by a. Of course here a is, x intercept is a is equal to 4 and y intercept is b, that is 3. And put here, you can find the slope minus b minus 3 by 4. This is a slope of the given line. And plot the graph. So its graph is, see, this is x, y, positive, negative x axis, negative y. Of course, here x intercept is positive value, here y intercept is also positive value. This is positive, this is positive, means x intercept is plus 4, means it will be on positive x axis, and y intercept is also positive, it will be on positive y axis. So its corresponding line is like this. So this is a straight line. Of course we can verify this acute angle. Definitely slope is negative. Yeah, slope obtained is negative. So here x intercept is how much? 4. Y intercept is 3. So this is the orientation of the straight line. And go for another example. 2x minus 3y is equal to 6. Right? So what to do? Just it is divided by 6 on both the sides. Now 2x by 6 minus 3y by 6 is equal to 1. So x by 3 minus y by 2 is equal to 1. Yes, it is convert that x by 3 plus y by minus 2 is equal to 1. Here x intercept is 3, y intercept is minus 2, y intercept is minus 2, then slope of the line, slope equal to minus b by a. Of course minus b is minus 2, a is 3, minus 2, a is 3, which is giving 2 by 3 is the slope, 2 by 3 is slope. Now its orientation, straight line orientation, that by the graph, simple, x, y, positive, negative y. So here x intercept plus 3, x intercept plus 3, just it is on positive x axis, and y intercept is negative, that is on negative y axis, right? Straight line that passes through these two points. So this is at what distance? 3 meters. This is at what distance? Minus 2. This part is. So this is the straight line. And its slope is very clear, we can verify. Theta is a acute angle. And definitely the slope will be positive. So this is in x and y intercept forms, equation is given. We can draw directly. So very simple x and y intercepts. Okay. Now, one more method is there to decide x and y intercepts directly. Suppose 3x plus 4y is equal to 12, equation given. Very simple, that closing this one, 4y, just 3x equal to 12 and x intercept is giving 4. and closing this one, y-intercept is giving 3. So this is x-intercept A, this is y-intercept B, and directly we can get it by this method also. Simply closing this y and 3x component, this is equating them, then x equal to calculated x is the x-intercept, y is y-intercept, that is A is equal to 4, B is equal to 3. This is another way to find. Okay, let us find the line equations when the straight line is parallel to y-axis and passing through a point on x-axis which is at a distance A. So this is a straight line. Let us find its equation. So here its angle is, it is made by, it is making an angle 90 degree with positive x-axis. It is 90 degree. Okay. Now slope is, in this case slope is, slope m is equal to tan 90. So slope is infinity. Right. So we know the line equation. So it is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. So what is the point here? So x1 comma y1, we consider this point as a comma 0, then x1 comma y1. Just put the values here. Y minus y1 is equal to 0, is equal to m, slope is infinity. X minus x1 is how much? A, right? So y is equal to infinity, x minus a, then infinity taking this side, y by infinity is equal to x minus a, something by infinity which becomes 0 is equal to x minus a, x equal to a. This is the line equation. So x equal to a, that is a straight line which is parallel to y axis and also passing through a point on the x axis perpendicular to it. Means it is parallel to y axis means definitely it is perpendicular to x axis, which is passing through a point which is at a distance a. Therefore x equal to a is the line equation. Similarly, when we consider a straight line which is parallel to x axis passing through a point on y axis, say it is a b. Now the coordinates of this point is 0 comma b, right? 0 comma b, x1 comma y1, that equal to 0 comma b, right? Go for the line equation. Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. In this case slope is, slope m is equal to, slope m is equal to how much? 0. Why? Because here theta is equal to 0, which is parallel to x axis. Angle made by the straight line with x axis is 0 because it is parallel. Therefore slope equal to tan theta, tan 0, 0. Therefore slope is 0. Then put here y minus y1 is b, is equal to slope 0 into x minus x1, 0. Then as a whole y minus b is equal to 0, y is equal to b. So this is the line equation. So whenever it is parallel to x axis and passing through a point on y at a distance b, okay? Yeah. So let us remind the points. First one is velocity time graph is given. It is passing through origin and its line equation is v is equal to at. Why? Because it is y is equal to mx line. Y is equal to mx. Straight line passing through origin. And slope of the velocity time graph gives acceleration. Therefore, a. Slope of velocity time graph gives acceleration. A. And on time, sorry, on x-axis time is considered. Therefore, this is t. On y-axis, it is velocity v. So, it is v is equal to at. V is equal to at linear equation which is passing through origin. So slope of velocity time graph gives acceleration. So very, very important. Okay. Yeah. Next, one more graph, velocity time graph again. But if you consider instead of slope, so area under velocity where area under velocity time graph gives displacement. Area under velocity time graph gives displacement. There are two uses by this graph. One is by finding the slope, and it gives acceleration by finding the area under the velocity time graph, which gives displacement. Suppose if you calculate area, area is equal to, so this area of the triangle, so here the graph itself is giving, bounding certain area when we consider a perpendicular line from here, so which gives a triangle, right angle triangle. So area under this curve, which is giving area of triangle, therefore half into base into height. So velocity into time, which gives displacement, simply base of displacement. Displacement. So this is also very, very important. So area under velocity time graph gives displacement, and slope of the velocity time graph gives acceleration. Okay.